Hi everybody, and welcome to the second video in this tutorial series for NoteDex. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use groups and tags inside a stack, and we'll also go over sort of conceptually what they mean. In our example system that we have here, we have a number of stacks that we've created, and if you remember in the first video, we talked about a project Artemis, which is the NASA rocket that is going to the moon beyond. So we have a project Artemis stack, as you can see here. And when I click in the stack, you'll see that we have a number of cards that we've already prepared. So first of all, let's talk about what is the difference between a stack, group, and a tag. So a stack is a group of cards. So we have different stacks, which could represent perhaps different projects or different areas of research, or just whatever you want to organize. Once you click inside a stack, all the cards that are part of that stack are shown. And on the left-hand side, you see any of the groups that you have created. You can think of groups as subfolders. And the subfolders might be different sections or different areas within that stack itself. So in the example that we have for Project Artemis, two groups that we've already created were project briefings and engine specs. We could add more groups, and I'll show you how to do that shortly. So the first thing is, let's say we want to add a new group to this stack. So you just go move the mouse to the left-hand side here, and we click on Add Group, and then we give the group a name. So in this example, let's have a group that we call Budget. As you'll see, we have now a new group called Budget, and if I click on that group, there are no cards in it, as you would expect. At this point, I can click back onto all groups and we see all the cards. If we click on ungrouped, we'll see any cards that have not been assigned to any existing groups. We click on project briefings, you see I've put one card already there. And engine specs, we also have one card. Before we go too far, if you want to move the order of your groups, you can do that by just doing a drag and drop on the name of the group. So let's say in this example, I want to just order the groups alphabetically. I can just drag and move the name of the group, and it will move the order of that group and these groups. Okay. Now, as I mentioned, we have some cards which are ungrouped, and the ungrouped view helps you identify quite quickly which cards are ungrouped and therefore if you want to be organizing that. And in this case, I do. Now, I'm going to move these cards into the different groups. And the way we do that currently is by clicking the three dots in the top right-hand corner of a card. You cannot at this stage drag and drop a card to the name of a group, but we are working on more drag and drop features over the coming months. So to move a card, you just click the three icons, three dots, and we get a number of options which are for that card. And about one third of the way down, we see it says move to group. So in this case, I'm going to move this card called Mission Goal, and I'm going to move it to Project Briefings. So I just move my mouse and click the word Project Briefings. This next card is a budget. So as we would expect, I want to put that into the project budget group. So I click on the three dots, move to group. Here come we see again the different options. Make sure that you've moved your mouse and you've highlighted in blue the one that you want, and then just click and it's moved. Engine specs. Well, I think that should go into engine specs. And mission details. Well, that's probably going into project briefings. Okay, so now we see all the groups, and if we click through the different groups, we'll see all the cards as we expect. Now let's go into the next area, which is what are tags? So if we click on a card and we see here that we have the card that's opened up, and in order to tag a card, we use the icon at the top with the little drop down arrow that says card tag. Now, in this case, we've already pre-populated some tags. The first thing to remember is that cards can have tags which are specific to that stack, or tags that are available across all your different stacks. Now, we've done this because in some cases, you don't want to see all the different tags across all your different stacks when you click the dropdown. However, in other cases, you may well want to do that. So we've given you the flexibility and you can do one or more of those options. If you notice in the tags that I have, we have one called engines and then a couple of to-dos in progress and completed. If you click on edit tags, this is where you can add and edit the tags that you have. As you can see here, I mentioned earlier, there are some tags which are specific to a project and some which are global. So we see in this tag dialog box, the drop down at the top that says Project Artemis. So that's the name of the stack. And if I click that drop down, you see the names of all the other stacks in our application currently. We see engines as one of the tags that we've created. So now let me create another tag that'll be local to the Project Artemis stack. And in this case, we've got engines. Maybe I'll create one called goals. And then I can change the color of the tag if I want to. And maybe green is a nice color for the goal. And you can see here, I clicked on the background color icon and I picked green. And then we click on create tag. And now we see goals. You'll also see that engines, I sort of used a lowercase e, and I want to edit that. So I could just go back to edit and I can then fix that tag name and then I'll save that again. So now we've got engines and goals, which are tags in Project Artemis. So at this point, we can then click the dropdown. Now, in order to tag a card with this label, I just pick the item that I want, and we've now selected goals as the tag. I'm just going to save this card and go back to the screen before to show you now that any cards that are tagged, you see the tag above the card with the color. So this is a nice visual view of your cards, and you'll be able to rapidly view all the different cards with the different tags in the future. You'll also notice that at the top of the screen, we have the filter, and you can filter by tags. So in this example, it's going to show all the different tags that are available to be filtered on. So this is not all the tags in the system, but just the tags that are in that stack. And we've only tagged one card at the moment, so that's why it's only showing the goals. So if I click on goals, we've obviously filtered down all of the colors to just that one. If I go back to the card itself, you'll also know that if you click the slider from the bottom of the screen, you get the preview slider of all the other cards in the stack as well. And just like on the thumbnail view, you see the tag here in the slider view. So that again gives you a nice visual view and a way to sort your cards. Now let's talk about global tags. So global tags are tags that are available across all stacks. To get to the global tags, again, you do the same before and you click on edit tags, but this time you select the first dropdown, which says global tags. When you see global tags, you see the three tags that we included here that we wanted available across all our different cards. Again, if I want to add another global tag, I can do exactly the same and enter in the name, pick a color and create the tag. So let me just show you how global tags work if I was into another stack. So let's pick our Star Trek story stack. And let's say that I click on my first card in that stack. So what you'll now see here in the tag menu, we'll see various tags that are local to the Star Trek story stack. And at the bottom of that list, again, the three tags which were global. So we give you the option as to whether tags should be local or global. And if they're global, you can see them in all your different stacks. And just like before, if I want to pick one of these and flag it, I can do that. In order to delete a tag, let's say I don't want to do that after all, just click the X button on the tag and it gets removed. So we've now shown you how you can use groups and tags to organize your cards. NoteDex is definitely very flexible, and it really does depend on how you want to organize your information. But again, just to remind you, we often look at stacks as sort of different projects, different high-level groups of information. They might be different clients that you're working with, different lessons that you're studying, different stories that you're writing. Then inside a stack, you can have different groups, which are just like folders on your computer. You're moving the cards into those folders, those groups. The tag, on the other hand, gives you more of a dynamic view, and you can tag many cards with the same tag and you can filter on them. So that's more of a dynamic view. So for instance, if I wanted to also, well, let's do this. Let's say the mission goal was also something that I needed to do something with. So we've given it two tags, and the mission budget is one that I want to flag as part of goals, just for instance. So you'll see here, now we can have cards with more than one tag and across many different cards. And therefore, again, if I want to filter on them, I can do that. And NoteDex makes it really nice and easy for you to use tags to quickly view your information. Okay, that was a lot of information in this video. I know it was a bit long, but stacks, groups, and tags are really important, and they will help you organize your information in any way that you want it. So we hope that you found this video helpful, and please let us know if you have any questions or any suggestions of things that we can do to improve. Thanks very much, and we'll see you in the next video.